shoot, and they get the, and the team that was fouled gets the ball at the sideline.
It's very similar to the clear path foul of the NBA, where
exactly,
again, if you're just trying to stop a play, then it did, without going for the basketball, they'll give you that free throw and the basketball back. Very similar. FIBA made that rule change. I think, was it this year or was it last year?
Last year.
Yeah.
Yeah. They made a couple of changes, and you know, including the traveling.
The traveling is changes.
Right. Of course, they never really always enforced a 3-second rule unless it was really about 4 or 5 seconds in the lane. You know, back court.
And there's your final whistle. It is CB Bethel taking game one, 36-27. And they now up 1-0 in this best of three, a chance to sweep and claim a championship tomorrow night. We'll have to see what happens there, but set up right now for tonight's championship game on the senior boys side, where we're gonna see CeCe Sweeting going up against a surprise entrant for a lot of people, Anatole Rogers, who knocked off C.I. Gibson in very dramatic fashion, a three-point shot. Mind you, well-drawn up play, worked to perfection with a second on the clock. And the end result is you know, they're on their way to a championship. But I tell you what, man, I'm excited about this. I think Anatole's going to give CC, if they can hold their composure, I think they can give them a bit of a run.
I believe so as well. You know, I was actually surprised that Anatole was actually able to pull it off against C.I. Gibson. I was at that game. I had an appointment to keep. I was trying hard to stay until the end of the game.
That's
and I left.
It.
I left Anatole down about double digits.
Yes.
And then I was surprised the next morning, because I went to help CC Sweeting work out the next morning. And when I looked at the WhatsApp, there was a dramatic finish that they had circulating around WhatsApp that went viral.
Yeah, it certainly was. I mean, everybody, and the kid Andre Calvert, I remember this kid very well, because when I coached at Temple Christian, he was a freshman in grade 7. And he ended up being a starter on my senior boys team over a lot of kids. And just because of his length, he had at that point in time, still was a very good shooter, even though he was just coming into the high school era. And to see him now at Anatole Rogers, it does say a lot to me. I'm like, wow, this kid's really good. But I always knew he'd do well because he was a hard worker. Every time you saw him after he picked up basketball, because he played soccer originally,
mm-hmm.
and then once he picked up basketball, he really committed to it, and he tried his best to get better. He practiced constantly, and I saw where his ceiling was very, very high.
Especially making a big shot like that, taking your team over the top, getting them to the actual championship game and to the big dance. Nobody really expected Anatole Rogers. Anatole Rogers was a very difficult team to scout because they have a lot of new players, a lot of no-name players. I believe they only have about 3 or 4 guys on the whole roster that came back that has any playoff, any basketball experience.
And listen to this crowd react to the entrance of the Anatole Rogers Timberwolves. They actually have a pretty good fan base here to support them tonight. And that could be very important as this game goes on to rally them perhaps in tough situations, and certainly to keep them going as this series and this game progresses tonight.
Well, Anatole Rogers has always been well represented ever since the school came into, and since the school has opened, almost every sport they've always been very well supported.
So guys, we're moments away from the start of tonight's championship game one between the Timberwolves of Anatole Rogers and the CC Sweeting Cobras. Anatole coming out in their blue unis. I like the style. Got the little, everybody's going with the camouflage look a little bit now in their uniforms, except CC. CC and they're very representative of their coach, isn't it? Mario is a very one of those traditional style guys, and so his uniforms will reflect that. Meanwhile, Coach McCoy, perhaps a little bit more loose in terms of that aspect, and so you see his guys maybe showing that in the way the uniforms are designed and everything else.
A little bit of history. Actually, Mario Boleg and Coach from Anatole Rogers,
Coach
McCoy,
yeah.
They both went to Air Vadley together. They both have some history together. They both played for Doug Collins back in the day.
Really? Is that right?
In the 92-3-4 era, they played for the coach at Air Vadley, Doug Collins at that
Doug
time.
Doug Collins, yeah.
Yes. I haven't seen Doug for a while. Is he still around?
I haven't seen him either. I think he's still around. But you're right. I couldn't tell you where he is or what he's doing at this stage. So here you have both teams on the floor. Both teams on the floor getting ready for tonight's ball game. and we'll get those rosters for you in a few seconds. Meanwhile, let's take a moment. We'll be right back. We have championship action right here on RTV after this. We are set for game one. And as with most things like this, especially when there's television coverage, you know, there's always a little pump and pageantry ahead of the game. We won't actually get a chance to go right into this thing as much as we'd like to. We're gonna have a little bit of a program set up, so I guess we'll have to deal with that until we get to the actual game. But they're gonna start things off with the usual. Yeah, the prayer and the national anthem and everything else. But once we get past that, man, we're ready for some basketball action in mere moments. Bear with us. Give us a couple of minutes, and then we'll get into gameplay. But in the meanwhile, you know, the two teams are going through their warm process. If you're looking at your screens, it's CeCe Sweeting in the blue. I don't even know what color blue that is. It's like a turquoise, whatever have you. And then the full sweats, let's put it that way. And then CeCe Sweeting, there you go. That's CeCe Sweeting. In the white, they're the home team this evening, which means that the team you'll see in the darker color will be your away squad, that being Anatole Rogers. We welcome you to our coverage of the GSSA Basketball Championships. Marcellus Hall here with you alongside Antoine Francis, who will be rejoining me in a second. Well, you know, we got to get that other, we got to make sure we have our roster so we can let everybody know what's happening as it's happening, who's doing what. But yeah, we anticipate a great game tonight. This series, again, Anatole Rogers coming into this, I don't think anybody would have picked them to be where they are now, which is being in a position to play for a championship. Especially once the playoffs started and we had C.I. Gibson in there, who was a perennial entrant into the championship series. But never say die, and certainly it's a testimony to believing in yourself, because the Anatole Rogers Timberwolves going up against C.I. Gibson decided, you know what? We can win this thing, and they did just that. And I got to tip my cap to Coach Harcourt McCoy. And again, I go back to that last game, that game three, and with 1 second on the clock, and the play he draws up to get a shot off with a second and a good look at that, and it ends up going down. Andre Calvert knocking it down was tremendous, and it shows you really what's capable, what our coaching staffs are capable of here in this country. You know, I hear a lot of people talk about coaching and the level of play. You know, I've seen basketball. I've been around basketball for a long time. And I got to say that, yes, maybe we don't have the size, you know, that a lot of the different countries. And you know what? That's not even true, because if you look at basketball in the U.S., for instance, people like to compare us to American, to the U.S. basketball. Listen, there are schools certainly that have size, and their level of play is tremendous. But I'll give you an example. Say, for instance, this very same, that C.I. Gibson team that just lost. They were in a tournament a few weeks ago in Tennessee where they beat teams that were American-based, that supposedly have all the coaching and all this stuff that is so much better than we are. But yet our teams go away. You talk about Tabernacle and all that. They go away on a regular and win games and contest for championships in tournaments against high schools in America all the time. So certainly to say that we don't have the coaching capacity here, I think it's an insult. Bruce.
Let me explain something to you. You know, we have faced that for many years. but we have professional minded coaches that go and get training, that go to clinics, that try to improve themselves, that try to get game experience, not only for themselves, but also for their players. They research, we pool our resources, and we get together and try to learn this game and try to improve ourselves on what it is to do. The next thing you have to understand is when players execute from a play that you draw up,
yes,
that is what kind of get people to believe that, okay, maybe he or she can coach. When you get the kids to buy into your program and your philosophy, and they go there, and what the operative word would be is trust. But now we're going to take it to the floor at center court, where we have the beginning of the opening ceremonies of the GSSA Championship Series between CC Sweden Cobras and Anatole Rogers Timberwolves.
Ms. Joan Gray, president of the Principals Association, and she is also the principal of CC Sweden Senior High. Ms. Cheryl Samuels, principal H.O. Nash, Mr. Keith Sands, Mr. Sumner, Mr. Bacchus Roll, Mr. Toynquist, Mr. Boleg, Mr. Thurman Johnson, and representatives from the GSSA executive body. We would like to begin, as we have your attention, for the prayer, which will be done by Mr. Thurman Johnson, teacher at C.H. Reeves.
Let us stand for prayer, please. Let us bow our heads and close our eyes and reverence God at this time. Thank you very much. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord, as we come before your presence this evening, we do thank you, Lord, for this opportunity you've given these kids to play in the game of basketball. Father, we pray, God, you'll keep them safe from any injuries. And Father, we pray, God, as they partake of this game, Lord, and participate, we pray, God, that you would be with the coaches, give them wisdom as they coach their team. And may every player that come on this court tonight demonstrate good sportsmanship. And Father, we pray, God, you will be with the officials, give them wisdom as they officiate the game tonight. And Father, whatever is done, we step aside to give you all the honor, the glory, and the praises. We pray these things in Jesus' name with thanksgiving. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Johnson. Before we start with our national anthem, we would like to welcome our teams, CC Sweden Cobras, champions, Anatole Rogers Timberwolves. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as we invite Mistress Demetrius Smith, teacher at C.H. Reeves Junior High. She will lead us in the national anthem.
Lift up your head to the rising sun, Bahamaland. March on to glory, your bright banner.
We're now going to have our welcome address, and this will be done by Ms. Shakira Farrington. She's the second vice president of RGSSA Association.
Ministry of Education Sports Unit, Mr. Evan Wisdom. President of the Principal Association, Ms. Joan Gray. GSSA President, Ms. Varel Davis. Alive in Cape of Bahamas, sponsors, other invited guests, principals, team, coaches, and fans, good evening. It is with great pleasure to welcome you to the 25th Silver Year Basketball Championship. It is a strong commitment to basketball and to the development of our youth is the reason why we have all gathered here. This event speaks for the commitment that all of us hold for the sport. I am sure that we will witness athletic performances of the highest quality over the course of this championship. Do your best and compete in the spirit of sportsmanship and fair play, and take the opportunity to come closer to each other. Once again, welcome to the GSSA 25th Basketball Championship. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Farrington. We're now going to have brief remarks, and it will be done in this order. Ms. Varel Davis, GSSA President, Mr. Evan Wisdom, Ministry of Education Sports Unit Representative, and Mistress Joan Gray, President of the Principals Association.
A pleasant good afternoon. Once again, welcome to our 2018 championship. It was not an easy road to get here. Last week in the gym, we had the most exciting best of three playoff event. What you have here today, you have number 14 place, Anatoly Rogers, versus the third place team, CC Sweden. Congratulations to both teams, well done boys. And we want to say, this is our 25th year anniversary. This is very special to us. So this year, we want to salute our founding members and our past president on the development of the youth that they did in the past. Once again, to all players, do your best. Compete in spirit of sportsmanship and play fair play. I want to say good luck to both teams and may the best team win.
Thank you very much. I just wanted tonight, I need you to be quiet for me, please. I just wanted tonight to congratulate you. You made me so proud tonight when you sung that national anthem. You couldn't hear a pin drop. Give yourselves a round of applause, please. Come on, y'all could do better than that. Thank you so much. Number two, we have two improbable teams here. These two teams were not supposed to be in this final. Somehow, they mustered up what it takes to be a champion. And so the word I have for everybody out there that's listening to me tonight, never give up. These two teams, y'all can give them a round of applause. They never gave up. The second thing, in the Ministry of Education Sports Unit, we like to highlight heroes. There's a gentleman here, Keith, could you come up for me, please? Mr. Sands? This gentleman represents a service club here in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. He takes his personal time to work with the C.I. Gibson Rattlers, assisting them with tutoring and mentorship. I thought it very, very important tonight in a national way to thank Mr. Sands for all of the wonderful work he's done, and I want you to know those young men are soaring in terms of their grades, and it's because of persons like this who do not get paid, but give of their personal time, that they could be with their family, and give to the wider family of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Let's give Mr. Sands a rousing round of applause, please. Thank you, Keith. Last but not least, I want to say thank you to the president of this association. She and I worked together to be able to pull off these events. And I want to pay special homage to Ms. Joan Gray, principal of C.C. Sweeting High School. Give her a round of applause for all of her leadership and her support. Support is what enables us to win. So on behalf of the Minister of Education, our director, Mr. Marcellus Taylor, all of my colleagues at the Ministry of Education, I want you to know tonight that both of you are champions because of the mere fact that you've reached a championship, and no matter what happens during these 3 days, I'll see you in Freeport, Grand Bahama for the National High School Basketball Championships. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wisdom, and all other special guests this evening. Are you ready for the big dance? Are you ready for the big dance? Have you enjoyed the game so far? Well, tonight we have the Timberwolves and the Cobras. This is going to be an absolutely fantastic game tonight. And we wish to thank all of our coaches, our officials, our president of GSSSA, and all the executive members, and also all of the other officers of that association. It is my extreme pleasure on behalf of the New Providence Association of Principals of Public Secondary Schools to say to each and every one of you athletes here tonight, you are already a winner. And you will do your best on this court tonight, because come tomorrow, we will be determining who is taking the championship. Who will win this game tonight? Who will win championship? Let's game begin. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much to all of the awesome representatives. We're now gonna have our vote of thanks as we bring this opening ceremony to a close, and that will be done by Ms. Fiona Tucker, and she is the Assistant Secretary of the GSSSA.
Good evening all. On behalf of the executive members of the GSSSA, I would like to extend a special thank you to all of you who celebrate with us this evening at the GSSSA 2018 Basketball Championships. A special thank you goes out to our president, Ms. Pharrell Davis, Mr. Evan Wisdom, Ministry of Education Sports Unit, Ms. Joanne Gray, President of the Principals Association, for their timely remarks tonight. In addition, thanks to our moderator, Ms. Keisha Pratt, Mr. Thurman Johnson for the prayer, and Ms. Shakira Farrington for our welcome address. To our coaches, parents, family, and friends, thank you for your continuous encouragement and support. We are indeed touched by the presence of each person here tonight because it shows us how much you really care. Last but not in any way least, a heartfelt gratitude and sincerest appreciation to our sponsors, Alive and Cable Bahamas, for your dedicated and selfish service to us and for making this basketball championship a success. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all.
Thank you very much. And last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, We have a special person coming on, and you're gonna love this. But before we do that, CC Sweeting, are you ready?
Gentlemen, thank you first of all for coming out and supporting Bahamian basketball. Let's give it up for you. Let's give it up for us. Now introducing our starters for our visiting Anatole Rogers Timberwolves. Number 00, Kirkland Farrington. Number 4, from Long Island, Tayshaun McCarty. Number 7, man in the middle, Allen Williams. Also joining him at forward, number 15, D'Angelo Hicks. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Big Shot himself. Number 11, Andre Calvin. The Anatole Rogers Timberwolves are coached by head coach Harcourt McCoy, assistant coach Spurgeon Johnson, assistant coach Anthony Swaby. Now, the CC Sweeting Gophers! Coming in number 13, Cassius Turnquest. Number 2, Antoine Williams. Number 11, DeAndre Near. Number 10, Brandon Strong. And 2016-2017 All Bahamian Brand selection, Marco Beckford. Ladies and gentlemen, the CC Sweeting Cobras are coached by your Bahamian Senior Men's National Team head coach, Mario Boland. Assisted by Calvin Cummings and Coach Wade Adderley. Ladies and gentlemen, shake hands, come out fighting.
The starting lineups have been announced for both teams, and we're ready in mere moments to start this thing off. And you can tell by the excitement level when they announced the teams, and certainly, you know, they got into the crowd. And as I was mentioning earlier, this Anatole Rogers team is well supported here tonight. We'll see if that translates to them being able to to come out with a victory. But I think both teams have persevered to get where they are, and now it's just about execution. Again, you know, they mentioned the fact that Mario Boleg is a senior national team coach, and certainly that may be, to a degree, an advantage for CC Sweeting, but certainly
ladies
can't discount Harcourt McCoy either and his ability as a coach. Certainly got his team where they are right now against another very, very good coach being KJ Johnson, who is very seasoned and experienced.
But this is what I'd have to say about it. Like you said, don't discount Harcourt McCoy and his coaching staff, because Harcourt was also a national team coach on
That's
the junior
right.
level.
Yes, yes.
Spurgeon Johnson was a national team player, junior boys national team player. Coach Smaby was a national team coach, men, women, and he was also selected by Jamaica at one point in time to be a national team coach. So, you know, you have a wealth of coaching knowledge there.
Yeah, certainly, and I guess it's going to come down, like we always say, to execution, because coaches can draw plays all you want. You can X's and O's and call timeouts and everything else, but it does come down to being able to execute on the floor and to get a good look at the young man in street clothes there for CC Sweeting.
That's Joshua Anderson.
Yeah,
he came out of my
him.
Program. He dropped plump on his hand and broke it in two
places.
I was
actually at that game doing that play-by-play for 10th year seniors on that night, and watched that play happen. And you know, immediately as soon as it did take place, I just knew. I said, well, you know, he's definitely.
That's the season.
Yeah, and I said, man, this kid just broke his hand.
And he's a tough kid.
Yeah.
He was supposed to play high school football in the United States, but he didn't get sorted out in time. He also is a junior black belt in karate, so I know he's very tight. He's a tough kid.
Yeah.
You know, I teased him. I said, you should know how to fall. You know, should know how to break the fall. You know, but, you know, he's there giving them moral support. And also, to swing it back to the Anatole Rogers side, Dominic Bridgewater, a.k.a. Nato, is back in the Bahamas. Former national, well, not wouldn't say formula, former because he's still a national team
sure,
player.
Yes, yes.
You know, 2 years ago he was the MVP, and here he is now back in the Providence, and he'll be probably be on that Hugh Campbell roster. And he's dressed now on the Anatole Rogers bench, but obviously, you know, he won't play.
Yeah, and we'll see how this all turns out at the end of the day. Again, starting lineups looking like this, CC Sweeting go with Anton Williams, Marco Beckford, Brandon Strawn at center. He's the team captain, sorry. Dondre Nairn and Cassius Turnquest. For Anatole Rogers, they're going with Kirkland Farrington, Jason McCarty wearing number 4, number 7, Alan Williams, and then there's number 11, Andre Calvert, who we saw make that dramatic shot to get them to the championship in the first place, and then number 15, D'Angelo Hicks. So, well matched. I think they match up in terms of starting lineups. I think it's very balanced, and I guess it's going to be which team has the depth and the capacity to go a little bit deeper in their bench.
I was just about to ask you, what do you think is going to make the difference in this game tonight? I really believe whoever goes for the 50-50 balls, like you said, whoever executes the most, who gets out on the break, and most definitely, who rebounds that ball well.
Yeah, and that's what it always boils down to. But in particular, in a matchup like this, where both teams are very aggressive defensively, in particular CC Sweeting, they like to play that frenetic pressure style defense, try to turn you over. I think it's going to be critical in these first couple of moments as we get ready for open turnoff, tip-off. It's going to be very critical for Anatole Rogers to withstand that storm, that early storm.
I'm going to tell you this. CC Sweeting is going to throw any and everything at them. Like I said, I've been intimately involved with the practice sessions. I've seen how passionate the coaching staff is. I've seen how the players have come along and how they rallied together, and I expect to see a lot on the defensive side from CC Sweeting.
And we are underway. First possession in control. Anatole Rogers having the basketball and looking to get something going offensively. Quick jump shot, no good. Rebounded by
Brandon Strong.
It's Brandon Strong, and they have their first possession. Let's see if they're a little bit more patient now to start this game. And it is CC basketball really already more patient because they've made 3 or 4 passes already and moving that basketball around, looking and probing. There's a 3-point shot, no good off the front of the rim by number 10. That's Brandon Strong, who couldn't hit. He was very good in the playoffs round early on. Another 3-point shot again by Strong. He hasn't come close on 2 attempts. So let's see if maybe the next time he makes a try to put the ball on the floor and try to go to the basket. Ball knocked out of bounds. It will be Anatole Rogers basketball. So they'll get a second look at it. But again, like I said, these first couple of minutes is going to be crucial for them. This time a lot more patient. Calvert finds himself open to three-point shot. No good on the air ball. And you know, this is a different environment than AF Adley. The shooting, the confines a little bit different. The depth perception's a little bit different. So it takes the shooters a little bit of a chance to get a little while to get adjusted to this thing. We'll see how long it takes both squads.
Just now, CC Sweeting rebounded the air ball, but Brandon turned it over off his leg. As we have number 00, Mr. Fryington, taking another three-point shot and missing.
And now Brandon. CC pushing it. Now he does try to go to the basket again. We have yet to have a basket. And I think a little bit of nerves coming into play now for both these teams. Going to have to settle down as this game progresses. Some of it's, again, as you're in the championship, good defense on the interior. But some of it also has to do with the fact that these guys are well aware they're on national TV here, so that also plays into it.
Most definitely, as Jason McCarty penetrates.
McCarty normally makes that shot, can't hit. There's a whistle, he had a first basket and a foul. So fouled on the shot for Anatol Rogers is Allen Williams. A chance here now for a three-point play.
The hard way.
Foul was called on CC Sweeting's Anton Williams, his first personal and the team's first. As it completes a three-point play, we have our first score in a 3-0 game. Here come the Cobras looking to answer, getting across the timeline. They've settled for a lot of jump shots to start this game. There's another one, and this time it goes down. As usually happens, once the scoring starts, it comes in bunches. Three-point basket dropping in for him. Meanwhile, an ugly-looking layup attempt. No good. Players fly everywhere. That's Calvert that went down. Meanwhile, here's CC Sweeting pushing it up the floor. Going in strong. The left hand, no good. Ball knocks around and out of bounds off CC Sweeting.
Yeah, it's a little difficult to see the colors because, you know, Anatol is in white and CC is in that high silver, metallic-type silver.
Yeah, very similar is right. Calvin for three. No good.
He shot two air balls so far.
Meanwhile, an offensive rebound, a putback inside by Anatol Rogers.
As Anton Williams brings the ball up the floor, he's been compared to Dominic Bridgewater, saying that he's about 15 pounds away from being an elite Bahamian point guard.
Well, I guess we'll take a good look at him tonight. Meanwhile, there's another three-point shot, this time off the back of the rim, fighting inside for the rebound as Calvin comes away with it. And here comes CC Anatol Rogers. Offensive foul to call that. Now, I thought he did a great job of evading the defender there. A little bit of a flop, but the referee gives him the benefit of the call.
I guess because he was outside of the no-foul zone, and he absorbed the contact a bit.
Kirkland Farrington picking up the foul. That'll be his. We'll actually give it to McCarty, so that's his first person. Another three-point shot. Well, they found the range a little bit now. They're two for about seven, which if you do analytics, I guess that's a good percentage. I don't know. The basketball purists will tell you, no, this new style of basketball, hey, chuck them up, and if you make a few of them, it usually adds up. Now Calvert going inside and puts it in.
It was a nice seal, nice recognition. I know Coach Boleg is going to be livid about that because they worked on that same short corner, that same back door, and not allowing players to penetrate in that position.
Yeah, there was no defensive rotation at all on the initial drive. First of all, he gave him the baseline to begin with. And now another three-point attempt, no good, but the offensive rebound is in there.
I believe the putback was by Dondre Nairn.
Cardi gets his man up in the air, loses control, inside, fighting for it, putting it down. And that's Allen Williams able to score underneath.
Allen has been big on the ball just now. He deflected a shot earlier in the game. He ran up and got two offensive rebounds with putbacks. He's been to the free throw line already. He has 5 of the 9 points for Anatol Rogers.
Speaking of free throws, it looks like we're going to have a couple coming up after the free throw. There was a timeout called on the floor. Not sure who called it, but apparently one of these teams' coaches not pleased with the way they're playing to this stage and wants to talk it over. 3 minutes, 37 seconds on the clock. It's a 9-7 ball game. Anatol Rogers up by two against CC Sweeting in the first quarter. And Antoine, I got to ask you, what are your thoughts so far as we've watched basically a quarter, just about three quarters of a quarter going down?
What I've noticed is uncharacteristic of CC Sweeting. They only pressured the ball one time up the floor so far. I believe they're going to bring some pressure on, because I believe that what Coach Molek doesn't want is for them to scout him out early in the game and make adjustments. At this point in time, it's still pretty much a close game. And at the same time, both teams haven't really pushed the ball up the floor as they are normally characteristic of that helter-skelter type, and sometimes of quickly getting the ball up and down the floor.
That's very true. That's one of the things we talked about earlier in this game. We said CC likes to pressure you, and yet they have another three-point shot. That side of the floor has been good for them to this stage. Anatol Rogers is going to have to make that. They're going to have to make that adjustment.
And now you see that pressure. Diamond and one pressure after a made basket.
Inside, strong, good defense.
Well, they're letting him play.
All over the floor there. Somebody's got to pick it up. CC and a foul underneath.
And I guarantee you anything now, what's going to happen is whoever the point man is on the free throw, they're going to set up for a full court pressure on the made free throw.
And we just talked about the fact that they hadn't. I guess he's picking his spots. And it was a good time to drop it on him, the surprise pressure defense, and it resulted in a turnover.
So here we have Marco Beckford, who's one for two. Sorry, he made the first one of two so far. And just as I mentioned, they moved the big man. They moved Ethan Munnings. They pulled him back. Here we have some soft pressure. Diamond and one.
Another steal, turnover going the other way. Another basket.
And that's Marco Beckford again.
So now it starts to get danger territory here. Anatol Rogers again. And now they break the pressure, ready for it, and they throw it away again.
Now this is where Brandon sometimes gets out of hand, because he normally makes poor decisions sometimes, but it's good he didn't.
Off the backboard, and the bank was open on that one. And now all of a sudden, again, you talk about confidence and believing. CC Sweeting has got that confidence now. Well, he thought about taking that shot. That was from Steph Curry territory.
And what I noticed, a lot of the kids start trying to shoot from deep, but it's not a shot that they practice. They start trying to emulate the characteristics of that quick shot, the quick pullback.
Yeah.
And they're not following through properly, and they don't know how many hundreds of thousands of shots that Steph Curry.
Repetitions that went into that, exactly. The finished product is what they see.
Right.
And they try to finish do it themselves. 16-9 ball game. This thing started to get away a little bit. If you're Minnesota Timberwolves, but if you're Anatol Rogers, this thing started to get a little bit on the helter-skelter side. You need to stop here, and then you've got to put the ball in the basket. I think they got to see that ball go in the basket, start to feel a little bit better about themselves.
Well, here we have Brandon Stronen made a penetration. He missed the floater. He's normally very good at that, and it's an awkward shot for people to block because he's a pure lefty.
Thought about that three again. Now they're really committed, and that must come real deep off the backboard, and no good. They get another offensive rebound. That's the thing about long shots. Ball does tend to bounce long.
And again, there's no 24-second shot clock.
Well, it doesn't matter. Williams hits another three. They've made five so far in this first quarter. Finally, the bleeding stops after four straight turnovers. Anatol Rogers able to put one in the basket as Kelson Riley, who's checked into the game for them, and able to score and kind of give them some breathing room here. 19-11 with a minute 10, you see it on the clock there, left to play in this first quarter. Got to get out to that three. They don't. Luckily for them, it misses. Very close to a double dribble, and now they almost throw it away. Looks like CC would have touched it last, but very careless with the basketball has been Anthony Rogers in this first quarter.
Yeah, I think, like we said, the press was sprung on them, and they didn't know what to do. Coach called a timeout and tried to get them. A quick inbound play. CC Cobras wasn't ready at that moment.
And the basket was made by Anatol Rogers, number five. That's Kevin Thompson. So again, 10 points.
Guys, the two subs have come in and made two baskets, so that's maybe what they needed, a little change of pace. Foul called underneath in the meanwhile.
So here we have Ethan Munnings going to the line.
And he's also a fresh pair of legs on the floor. Foul was called on Anatole Rogers, number 12. That's Crispin Roll picking up his first. I missed it. Did he make that first one?
He missed the first one.
And rounds the second one around and in. And as he missed that first free throw, it reminded me of that pivotal game three the other day when both teams missed double figures free throws. C.I. Gibson and Anatole Rogers missed a ton of free throws in that game.
So with 24.8 seconds left to go in the first quarter, CC Sweden 20-13 over Anatole Rogers. I believe CC's going to hold for one.
Yeah, I think they will, unless they get a wide open look. And as I said, that they forced one up, no good. Boy, it's tough to tell the colors. I thought that was a rebound by Anatole Rogers. Instead, it's an offensive pickup.
I guess it's safe to say Anton Williams is going to hold for one. He's trying to get him to clear out to the corner shot.
Wide open. Look at the three that goes in. Why not? What a backbreaker. Three-point shot at the buzzer. Goes off the glass and in. Oh, it was a good closeout at the end. Just didn't happen to be a defensive closeout. Good defense, better shot, as they
right.
say.
Because he closed out pretty good. He got some elevation, and he didn't foul.
Yeah, just so happened the guy makes a great shot. We have come to the end of the first quarter, and our score, 23-13. CC up by 10. Anatole Rogers, some work to do, but a lot of basketball still to play.
As we get ready to get the second quarter underway, it's 23-13. CC Sweden leads Anatole Rogers Timberwolves by 10. And it'll be CC Sweden ball going into the second quarter.
Definitely see if maybe Anatole Rogers can make the kind of settle themselves down and fight their way back into this ball game. Still a lot of time left. The key thing is to hold your composure. Marcellus Hall alongside Antoine Francis bringing you tonight's game one of the Senior Boys Championship game here at the Kenilage Gymnasium.
What it appears is Anatole has decided to go on a one-on-one, and they finally got a turnover, forced turnover.
Blocked away underneath. And now a wide open breakaway layup. It's going to be blocked on the other side. Wow. And that's getting back on defense. Good hustle play by Anatole Rogers, not giving up on it, and getting back in there and making that defensive effort.
I thought Brandon Strawn had a clear pass to the basket. And
showed
was
the basketball a little bit
too
early.
Much.
Yeah. He tried to make it look pretty, held it out. Well, we got to do a little bit better than that on defense. That three-point shot is falling big time tonight.
And Cassius Turnquest is getting turned up right now. He just blocked.
He just made the three. He just made the three, then goes out and makes the block.
He better be careful because he might get called for taunting because he got inside Kirkland's face just now after he sent him for a shot. What they say in the NBA, get that shot out of here.
Go, as we say in the moments, get that weak thing out of here. Go get your nonsense.
Yeah. As we have KJ Nixon just got the inbound and turned the ball over.
which would have been a good sneak play to get it back to the person that inbound the ball, but the person inbounding the ball never came on the floor. As CC Sweeting brings the ball over into the half court, Brandon Strong controls. He penetrates, dishes. Another dish, too much passing. CC Sweeting maintains control of the ball.
He was wide open. Get him the basketball. They do. Off the glass. No good. And the tip in is good underneath.
That's Joshua Forbes, number 7, a transfer from Westminster. He's a very good rebounder, very good rim runner guy.
And you can see now the pressure is bothering Anatol Rogers big time. They are playing at the pace CC wants them to play at. They're being frenetic. They're being careless with the basketball. They're throwing it wildly, and it's resulting in a lot of turnovers. Yet another one here, and here comes CC Sweeting, a chance to build on this lead that's already at 28-13. They're starting to really take control of this thing. Anatol is in real danger territory.
And what happens is CC Sweeting has some good perimeter ball handlers, so they don't have to rush to get in. They don't have to mind too much about the pressure if Anatol brings somebody. And here we have Brandon Strong, penetrates and makes a floater.
Yeah, the defensive effort now by CC, by Anatol Rogers, sorry, has become non-existent.
Now we have Jason McCarty that goes in, but they call a blocking foul on Cassius Turnquest because he didn't take the contact properly. So Jason McCarty goes to the line for 4. Jason McCarty has been out to national team practice for the last 2 years straight. He's really grown, he's really developed, he's very strong, he's very poised. One thing I'd say about his game, he needs to work on his shot a little bit more, and he also needs to stop jumping to pass. So many kids in today's game still jump to pass the ball and put themselves in some bad situations.
Yeah, because if something closes off, now you're in a position where you either force a still throw it or turnover, or you travel with it, which is still a turnover. So, and you can see Coach McCoy now pacing the sidelines, trying to figure out what adjustments he can make.
You see the jacket comes off.
Yeah, that's
it. You see the straight tail comes out of the back. Then you know.
As McCarty misses the free throw, wide left, as they say.
He's normally a very good free throw shooter as well.
McCarty shooting the second, misses them both. That's a key. That's really, really not good if you're Anatol Rogers. You got to take advantage of these opportunities to try and claw your way back in. 30-13, the score. You see it on your board there. Driving baseline, good pass, good finish. And the onslaught continues.
That's Anton Williams that made the little scoop pass to Ethan Munnings.
Ethan Munnings able to finish.
Ethan has come a long way.
The 3, they need that. Doesn't fall for him. Rebound by CC Sweeting. 32-13, 5:21. Coming up on 5:21.
Anatol has not scored in the second quarter.
Yeah, they have yet to take the goose egg, the lid off the rim, if you will. Blocked away by Calvert, comes away with it. Will they get it right back? Another good look at the basket and in.
By Brandon Strong again.
And they're scoring practically at will. And it's got to be demoralizing for Anatol Rogers. They almost turn it over there again.
There's a lot of contact on that. He reached right in and bodied him up.
4:56 in this first half. Timeout has been called.
Almost half the quarter is gone, and Anatol Rogers has not scored. CC Sweeting has doubled their lead and some.
And what they've done also is take this crowd out of the ballgame. They were very enthusiastic early on in favor of Anatol. Get a good look at the replay here underneath. Seeing again the good ball movement, the hustle. They're getting all those 50-50 balls we talked about. And then finally the finish by Brandon Strong to finish it off. But again, and like I said, man, we talked about early on those 50-50 balls, which team is going to go after it more. And so far it has been CC Sweeting.
The 50-50 balls, and at the same time the rebounding shifted from the first quarter, which, and I thought that Anatol really had out-rebounded CC Sweeting, had out-hustled them. It has shifted now.
Now, is that Salathiel Dean, a.k.a. Donkey, I see on that CC Sweeting bench?
Yes, Salathiel is there. He's working with CC Sweeting, has been for the last 2 years.
Good stuff. Glad to see him getting into some coaching. He's been around the game. McCarty almost lost it out of bounds. Lost his dribble. Long cross court. That's a wild 3. No good. So now Now Anatol Rogers, just desperation heaves. Now they're not looking getting good offensive sets anymore. It's about just trying to jack things up. That's a good looking three and a miss off the backboard. We're gonna see a whistle underneath. Is it against? It is against CC Sweeney.
Yes.
And I think they may have gotten number 14. That's
Ethan Munnings.
That's Munnings who was called for the foul over the back. So a good break there for Anatol Rogers. You can see that diamond and one pressure. They break it nicely. I like that. And let's see if they can score. Oh, wow. Blocked as he went up with a shot attempt. A little bit too casual. And the defender able to deflect it. Nice spin move. And
oh,
no foul.
A lot of contact allowed.
Wow, referee says all ball. I didn't see that. But meanwhile, offensive foul goes the other way. So two good defensive stops there, if you will.
But they haven't capitalized on the other end.
Yeah,
they broke the press, two defensive stops. You got to convert some baskets. Other than that, you're defending for nothing.
Well, let's see if they can do something positive here offensively. McCarty has, I don't think he's rested.
What do you
game.
Notice now, Sellers? CC Sweeting has dropped the pressure off. Now they're switching it. They're in a 1-3-1. When the ball is to the side, they're in a box.
And looks like he missed.
Stayed in the lane, 3 seconds.
3 seconds, call underneath. So again, a turnover, even though it wasn't necessarily by the defensive pressure.
Yeah, because I still didn't like the defensive rotation just now because the guy was open wide in the corner on the cross-court pass.
Yeah, that should have been, that from that distance, it should have been picked off or at least
right.
Deflected. Absolutely.
So Marco Beckford walks the ball up the floor, calling a play with a pass, called a top head, calling for a screen. The pass is to Brandon, who penetrates. Bad pass, turns it over.
And they got a breakaway layup here. And can't convert. McCarty, though, there for the cleanup and able to finally get Anatol Rogers a bucket in this second quarter.
First bucket for the entire quarter. We are 5 minutes plus into the quarter, or just about 5 minutes into the quarter.
Yeah,
CC Sweeting's playing keep away now.
And that's the thing about the no shot clock, which I absolutely don't see the reason for that.
Well, they didn't play it all season, so there's no reason to try and bring it in.
Oh, nice shooting the gap. Fast break opportunity, and they lose it.
Brandon Strong with his floater.
He can't hit it. And now the good hustle defense finally, Anatol Rogers comes up. McCarty's open, throws it up, can't hit, foul called underneath. He got bailed out, I think. He should have made the layup initially. I think he was a little bit out of control once he caught it.
I'm seeing the body language from Anatol Rogers. They look deflated.
Yes.
They look tired. They look like they've already played an overtime game.
Well, here's McCarty. He missed his last two at the line. Let's see if he can figure it out. And the foul called on. There's a good look at it again. If contact actually came after the shot, but the referee gives him the benefit of the doubt, so he's going to the line here. Foul was called on CC Sweeting's Marco Beck for his second. Makes the first one.
Well, you know, the shooter's still in the act of shooting until he lands.
This is true. McCarty, can he make it two in a row? Does not. CC Sweeting controls the backboards, and here they come on offense again. 34-16 to score. 2 minutes and 30 seconds left in this first half of play. McCarty comes up with a steal. And very rare do you get that cleanly. A lot of times that's called a foul, whether you make contact or not.
I was thinking the very same thing.
CC going the other way, an offensive foul. Yes, indeed. Way to stay in there and take that
there
charge.
Were so many bodies in there. Now I see who it is. From CC Sweeting, that's Anton Smith, AKA Lips.
Yeah, he was called for the offensive foul. That's his first foul.
And coach has always had to talk to him about being out of control on his penetration.
Bad decision by McCarty that time, trying to dribble through four guys under pressure. He lost it and it's going the other way.
And that's what the pressure is designed to do, to get you in an uncontrolled dribble situation where you have to make either a bad pass or an errant pass. And again, CC Sweeting playing keep away. They're being very patient, as you spoke up earlier. They don't have the score. There's no shot clock to violate.
And they've got a comfortable lead, too. Now, So now if you're Anatol Rogers, you've got a good screen to get him open, wide open look from the ring. No good. Breakaway pass, can he finish it, is the question. He does. Basket by number two, that's Devin Barnaby, who's able to score.
So that's two baskets for Anatol Rogers in the second quarter.
It's a 4-0 swing to this point. And a chance here to make it a 6-0, 3-on-2 fast break situation. Can't hit.
So Anton Williams handles the ball nicely.
Oh, he got away. Good pass and Ethan Munnings, who was able to score.
Yeah, from Anton Smith to Ethan Munnings, he made a good decision just now in his penetration.
That's a bad shot, and it's sent back, and he hit the delete button on that thing.
Yeah, that's Cassius Turnquest again with the turnaway, with the rejection. Who is it, Marv Albert, that says rejection?
Yeah, indeed. And if you get a good look at it again, try to do the old reverse thing, and the defender says, no, thank you. Back in the days when people actually sent letters, we would say he didn't have enough posters on that thing. Return to sender. 3-point shot, not even close. And here comes CeCe Sweeting again.
And Anton Williams.
And
you can't say
that. Can't float that pass. And I saw that coming. Saw that coming. He turns it over. Slowed down, Kirkland Farrington did. And the defender able to get back into the play. He ends up losing it out of bounds. Just going for the layup. He tried to make it look a little extra. I think he thought about maybe going for a dunk.
That's Anton Williams again, turning the ball over by himself along the sideline.
And you get a good, and you can tell you right now, you can see Coach Mario Boleg has some choice words for him as he gets that sideline. Timeout called on the floor. It's a 36-18 ball game as CeCe Sweeting in control.
They've actually doubled Anatol Rogers' score.
Absolutely. And with 11.7 seconds left to play in this first half, it looks as if they're going to have a comfortable lead going into the locker room.
And you know, some people have asked, why you call a timeout with only 11 seconds left to go in the half and you're down by X, Y, Z? Every time you see this happen, a coach is taking an opportunity to present a teaching moment. Let me draw up a play. Let's go into the halftime with probably something positive.
Absolutely right on that. And even though you're down by a lot, if you can get a good basket here and a feel-good moment, like you said, it make you feel a little bit better about yourself going into the locker room. I like the ball movement here. Gets a good look at it. And like you said, there it is. And that's Calvert, who finally knocks one down. And they'll go into the locker room with our score 36-21. But a good moment there. Something
like
to take in the locker room.
Yes. They had some patience. They didn't have to rush. Ball moved around a bit. They used the clock. And they took a good high percentage shot from a good high percentage shooter.
That's right. Well, our half is upon us. It's a 36-21 ball game. CeCe Sweeting comfortably in front, but there is a second half of basketball still to be played here in the Kendall Lodge Gymnasium. We'll have it for you right here on RTV after this.
Hi, I'm Davrielle, and welcome to Rev Tips, where we ask your most important Rev Service questions. Today's questions are all about Rev Go Play, the new TV Everywhere app from Rev. How many devices can I use Rev Go Play on per Rev TV account? You can use up to 3 devices on Rev Go Play per Rev TV account, and you can stream live 2 devices simultaneously. How do I record my favorite shows on Rev Go Play? Simply select your favorite show, select record, and choose between current or series recording. How many NDV hours do I have and when do they expire? You can record up to 20 hours of content using your Rev Go Play NDVR. Your recorded content will remain in your storage folder for up to 30 days. How do I activate Catch Up TV or start over? If you've just tuned into your favorite show but want to start from the beginning, simply select Restart. If you have more questions about RevGo Play, feel free to visit the RevGo Play page on CableBahamas.com or call our support team at 601-2200.
Live the HBO Go experience. Online service with HBO's most selected content at your fingertips. Obtain the HBO Max package now and get the third month free. And start enjoying from any mobile or computer all episodes of your best series, blockbusters, and so much more. Make all the content from HBO yours. HBO Go is HBO wherever you want. Sign up for HBO from Rev and be entered to win an all-expense-paid trip for two to Hollywood to visit your favorite HBO set.
We're gonna have the halftime show by none other than Spicy.
Mic check, check, check. 1, 2. I'd go Marie Dizzle. Marie Dizzle. Marie Dizzle. Play like you won't see me in the crowd, boy. I'm not doing for my man.
Play it. Spicy DWNO.
All right then. We get the gemlin like right now, right now. We get the gemlin looks. So let me tell you about this. It's a funny story. Listen up. She ran up on me, said she want be my wife. But this girl so bad, she be she only want a picture just to get some light. This girl so sad, I really need to get a light. She all up on my wall, but she passing with the hearts and the kissy faces, I be laughing. She say, Spicy, don't stop my videos. Now she texting every night, but she won't come at me asleep. Grab me in the air, but I'm out so stink, close to get ya. Belly dead full, no, her belly never flat. So amazing what she can afford. She wearing high-waist jeans with the crop top. 5 weeks, me girls there. No soap, so she bathing with detergent. She can't remember when last she was up. She got an iPhone 6, but she I'm out there sleep, but she always I swear to God, but this girl but dusty. She got a gold teeth and a dead dress. What you call it? That's how they go. Yeah, girl, you know, wearing a fresh shoe, showing all her big toe. And we up there, nasty, looking like a scarecrow. Say she getting money, but where would that go? Ryan Yankin, truck out and doing. She in the dance, and she breaking all her back on. Dead drunk, you know why she can't do it. But that's what she doing for the fame, but niggas just for the this boy, all right, that's the new name, but you say she wanna hide, huh? But your frame, it. When they was a goon, she was shielding. She bleeds so much, now I can't feel it. I'm buying a beauty shop. One, two, one, two, three, six. Say, what a hair spicy. Oh, no.
So we are set in mere minutes for moments, I should say, for the start of the second half between the Anatol Rogers Timberwolves and the CC Sweden Cobras. Our score, in case you're just joining us, is getting a good look at it, 36-21 in favor of CC Sweden. And by the way, Marcellus Hall alongside Anton Francis here. And as we look back on that first half, first quarter, it looked balanced. I thought both teams were coming up maybe a little bit out of their game plan, but for the most part, you know, it looked like it was going to be a competitive ball game. And then CC started to hit a couple of threes, and then their confidence went up. And for whatever reason, Anatol went into panic mode early, and they haven't been able to recapture.
This is one of the things I'll tell you. From an old school classic coaching style, on a converted basket, we press. On a free throw made, we press. So after those consecutive three-pointers, after those consecutive free throws made, those were good opportunities for CC Sweden to set their defense up and then to put the pressure hard down on Anatole Rogers. And Anatole Rogers, like I said, they look very sluggish going into the second quarter.
Well, it will be Anatole Rogers basketball to start the second half. McCarty gives it up. And a cross-court pass again to McCarty. They're working a two-man game between McCarty and double zero Kirkland.
McCarty takes a three and misses.
Luckily, they get it right back. And it's blocked away. CC Sweeting with the basketball.
Well, with some good efforts just now by Dondre Nairn, blocking, getting the 50 ball.
Well, that looked like a walk. He got away with it. It's knocked out of bounds and should have been actually off after. I think the referee made up for it and gave it over to Anatole Rogers. We'll give you a quick rundown of the first half stats in a second, just to kind of give you an idea of who did what. But Brandon Strong had himself a first half, 15 points. And he shot, is it 5 of 11, 6 of 11 for the first half, 3 of 5 from down, is it 3 of 5 from two-point range. And how many threes did he make? 3 of 5 from outside the three-point line. And he's shooting 54.5%. That's pretty solid. And here's Andre Calvert at the line, shooting two now as a whistle was called underneath on the layup attempt. Calvert knocks one down. Now, and who's this leading scorer for Anatole Rogers at this point?
We have Alan Williams as the leading scorer with 7 points on the Anatole Rogers side. He's been 3 for 3 on his field goal attempts. He has no three-point attempts, of course, but he's the big man, so you expect him to have a higher field goal percentage.
Well, now you saw Anatole Rogers going into a press-type mode, trying to speed this game up a little bit from an offensive standpoint, defensive standpoint. But you can tell they're not used to it. There's a difference. You can tell a team like CC Sweden, they practice this continuously. That's their style of play. I could tell just from that way that thing was set up that they were uncomfortable trying to pressure the basketball the way they were.
Right. I guess they still look a little fatigued. They look a little winded.
Long three-point shot goes down. Kirkland Farrington dials one up from downtown and gets him to go. Well, they've made 2 3-pointers, one to end the half and one here. Cuts into the lead a little bit, 36-25 now. It's 11 points.
It was an 8-point swing because Anatole Rogers was down by 19 points.
Well, let's see if they can continue this trend. And the thing is not to feel like you got to get it back in one possession. Just take your time, chip away, and get you back. McCarty up ahead, they score. So here come the Timberwolves. Whatever Coach McCoy told him in the locker room is working so far. Still a long way to go, but it's under double digits now, 9 points. And again, a quick shot from outside.
And that was very ill-advised by Brandon Strong just now. He's supposed to be the team leader. He should know better than to take that type of shot. Now the lead is now down to 9.
McCarty with the offensive rebound, 5:40 on the clock. Long skip pass, 3-point shot, no good, came very close to McCarty, another one, tries to split the defense and loses it. Behind the back, and a block shot going the other way. Give it right back with a steal. And a blocking foul. The stadium announcer is getting a little bit excited over there.
I'm surprised he didn't say the Euro, you know.
Yeah, well, he did it prior to that. That's what happened. He said it again. He said it on that play right there. And you know what? I think it's my fault that he's actually gotten a little bit more vocal. I paid him a compliment earlier. At halftime, I was on my way to the restroom. I said to him, you did a good job with the announcing of the lineups. I think that may have encouraged him. Stupid me. But
as we have Marco Beckford just made two of his free throws in there. CC Sweden forces a turnover with the Diamond One press again. They turn the ball right back over.
So that's good for Anatole Rogers.
I mean, don't you think there's enough court for him to stay in bounds?
I know, right?
With no defenders around him. And Mauro Boleg is livid.
So here is, that's a long three from Calvert, knocks down another. And he's got the range now. He's starting to feel confident about himself. He's made three of them. And another steal here. Calvert ahead. Kiss it over the back of the pass, and they convert. Kirkland Farrington on the assist from Calvert. They need a basket here. Does CC Sweeting out of bounds? Anatole basketball. What a turnaround this has been. Just like that, the lead is down to 6 points. 38-32. This is very reminiscent of that game against C.I. Gibson. And they throw it away. But the momentum has certainly shifted. And that was a
circus shot by Brandon Strong.
And somehow it went in for him.
He loves that floater. But the ball looked like it got stuck behind
his
back.
Yeah, I think he kind of just threw that one up. And a foul on the other side.
That's one way to stop a fast break.
With 4 minutes left to play in this third quarter, it has suddenly gotten interesting here at the Kendall-Eye Gymnasium as Anatole Rogers has clawed their way back and made it a ball game.
To tell you what, I'm kind of glad. I didn't want to see a blowout game. I want to see some competition. I want to see Anatole Rogers have some kind of success. To a point, you know, I grew up in the area of Farrington Road. I had a lot of friends that went to CC Sweeting. After leaving SAC, I spent 1 year in CC Sweeting. I had a lot of friends that used to play ball with, and they recruited me. Come play ball one more year.
Yeah.
Like, what? And I happened to be playing outside one day with them, and Mother Pratt said, boy, you better come. I got something for you when you finish CC.
Yeah. And the rest is history.
Yeah.
There you go. You know, it's interesting, and again, as broadcasters, we don't really have necessarily a horse in the race. But from a standpoint of this being, you know, for television purposes, obviously you want to compare
the
game.
You want a good game.
Yeah. Calvert has got to go and can't hit that time. But I like the fact that he took it to the basket a little bit. Defense obviously playing for that three-point shot, and he decided to go to the glass.
Now, Anatole is coming with their diamond in one.
But again, like I said, you can see the comfort level's not there. Strong does a force-up running, and they get one. That's running. He's having himself a really nice game lead, and they throw it away again.
They were moving a little too fast. He gave the assist to the wrong guy.
That should have been a walk. But CeCe's getting everything, and it's finally they lose out of bounds. It will be Anatole Rogers' ball. But the lead was down to 6. Now it's back up to 10. And this becomes now one of those possessions where if you're Anatole Rogers, you've got to get something positive in this situation. And that was a bad pass. Yes, you want to get to the ball to the middle, but the defense, they had three defenders around that. That was not a good idea. And the end result is a turnover.
But once again, after that defensive effort and the offensive effort to try and get back in the game, Anatole Rogers once again is looking
fatigued. Yeah,
you know, when you're down and you have to expend on both ends of the floor, it's very difficult to get back and stay in
and
the game.
And sustain it, certainly. And that's the thing about getting down that much and having, like you said, to sustain a long defensive run like that and try to keep your offense going. It's just about weathering the storm if you're CC Sweeting at this stage. 42-32, 10-point game. 2:58, there's another three-point left wide open on the first down.
And once again is Anton Williams, a.k.a. Donkey. And here we have the ball tipped high in the backcourt. But that isn't 8 seconds yet.
McCarty finds an open teammate underneath, and it's good.
Now, there was poor rotation in the back there for CC Sweeting's press, and I've watched Coach Boleg stress time and time again how important it is to have the proper defensive rotation when you're playing this press.
That's a bad
and have so
foul.
Much pressure in the backcourt.
D'Angelo Higgs probably with that last basket. Meanwhile, a foul called on the Timberwolves number 12.
Crispin Rose.
That's Crispin Rose, who was checked into the ball game. That was an ill-advised play. And I didn't even know what he was doing there. He didn't look like he was reaching for the basketball. It was just a pure foul.
He got his body in the way on the sideline. And CC Sweeting plays keep away again.
And I think Coach Mario sees.
What did I tell you about Brandon Strong and that running layup he likes? That running floater type layup. He's pretty much perfected that, and every time he, that's like a patented move for him.
Well, you got to get out on that. And there's a long three short off the front of the rim to get the offensive rebound. Whistle called underneath on the drive, and they'll get two free throws out of it.
I think Anatol Rogers needs to try to stay away from the three-pointers unless it's a nice high percentage open shot.
Well, let the shooter shoot the three-point shot. Yeah, that would be Calvert. And on occasion, you know, you can go with Kirkland Farrington.
I think that was Farrington that shot it.
Yeah, very deep shot.
Very deep. He shot it from the G in the Kenneth Jill Isaacs emblem on the floor.
He took a 30-footer.
Now Chris Monroe just missed the first of two.
And
he misses two
further.
Now as Ethan Munnings rebounds the ball.
Pressure again by the Timberwolves, broken by CC Sweeney. They're going to get an easy look out of this. And yes,
but what did I tell you about Brandon Strawn and that crazy floating layup?
He's got that thing down pat. It looks ugly coming off the hands, but somehow finds a way to go in. That's a street baller right there. Another turnover by Anatol Rogers. Just as they get themselves back in the ball game, just like that, CC Sweeting stems the tide and extends the lead.
And they're very careless with the ball. And as you see, CC Sweeting is getting on the floor. They obviously seem to be the more conditioned team. They're diving on the floor, going after balls, jumping the lanes, jumping the gaps, getting the deflections if they're not getting steals.
Whistle underneath is going to send somebody to the free throw line again. And honestly, they haven't converted those either. So
that's Ethan Munnings again with the foul on the baseline. I think it's Farrington that penetrated. No, that's number five, Kevin Thompson.
Thompson at the line. The last foul was called on
Ethan Munnings.
Sweeney's number 14, Ethan Munnings. That's his third personal. And they cannot make free throws here. That is not a good sign.
So you have Anton Smith bringing the ball up the floor. He's normally a little lackadaisical with the ball, not as very careful with his handling. You have a high screen and roll. Anton Smith.
Yeah, I think they could pick right there. That's an easy foul. I think it's going to be on number 15. Going to get whistled for the bump there. By the way, some from out of Grand Bahama, Tabernacle Baptist has just won the senior boys title, I do believe. I know they won the game over Jack Haywood 60-56 a few moments ago, early in the evening, I should say.
See, some great jobs that Coach Clark at Tabernacle is doing and Coach Shaky Hall at Jack Haywood are doing.
Oh, good pass and a good block, better block, I should say. A lot of contact and wow. They're going to say it's out of bounds off of Anatol Rogers. Looked like he was knocked out of bounds on the play, but okay.
Like we say, sometimes it looks like, you know, they make up a call because of the contact that happened on the penetration just now. There was a lot of contact and no call. Here we have 30 seconds left to go in the third quarter. CC Sweeting up 49-34.
Is he going to try to floater again? This time he gives it up. Three-point shot. No good. Rebound by Anatol Rogers.
Nice outlet pass.
Rush the shot.
Basket should be good.
And they're going to give him the goaltender.
You can't get your hand in the net. And it didn't look like that would have gone. That's number five,
Kevin
Thompson.
It was a wild shot. He was just trying to avoid getting blocked. And the referee, Van Hutchinson, caught it all the way and called the goaltender. And now we're going to have the offensive foul called on the hook.
That's on Anton Smith. Like I said, he normally does some things that gets Coach Boleg really upset.
And
as we see, the camera pans on to Coach Boleg.
Yeah. Who was actually a little bit restrained, if we know Coach Boleg. As we say that, there he goes. And there's a good look at Coach McCoy. The degree's working good for Coach McCoy. Normally, if you remember him a few years ago, that's going to be a foul called on underneath by the push off by McCarty. He was trying to get position underneath the rebound.
Yeah, loose ball foul underneath the basket.
You remember a couple of years ago, I think he was the coach of CB Bethel at that time, wasn't he?
Who was that?
McCoy.
No, he was never at CB Bethel. He was either at Doris Johnson.
Doris Johnson, that's what it was. No, this is Doris Johnson. He's at Doris Johnson, right? He was at Doris Johnson. He was. They were in. I think it might have been the Hugh Campbell. And I recall that he was so worked up.
Now I was just about to say there should not be a bonus shot on that foul possession, because even though the foul took them over the limit, Jason McCarty's team, Anatol Rogers, still had possession of the ball because they shot it.
Yeah.
So that should not have been a foul shooting ball.
The refs got it right. Final 3 seconds. Can they get a good look at it? They do. Nobody stopped the basketball. Luckily, the shot misses. But, I mean, absolutely no defensive effort by Anatol Rogers. Dribble the length of the court. In 3 seconds, nobody stops the basketball. And very lucky for the Timberwolves not to give up a basket.
Well, to that particular note, if you remember, one of our coaches at SAC, Reggie Forbes, he used to be able to get the ball on the floor in 3 dribbles and said it, man. He taught us kids how to do that.
Throw the ball ahead, that's right.
Get the ball up the court.
49-36, we have one more quarter to play. It's a lopsided affair. Timberwolves showed some signs, but have allowed CC3 to take it and recreate the lose lead.
I want to make a point about the officiating tonight. Officiating seems to be very balanced. It seems to be pretty good. There are no outrageous calls or anything like that. I think officials are doing a good job. Calls that can go either way, I believe the right decisions have been made, and when a correction needed to be made, I saw the official Christian made the other officials aware of the particular situation, making sure he checked with the table to say that, hey, they're not just over the limit, but the situation doesn't call for the opposing team to get any advantage by shooting a free throw.
Very much on top of things. And as you saw, I kind of read lips there with McCoy. Something I saw him say, you've got to get back. And that's one of the things, if they go on to lose this game, and certainly it's not over and done with, one of the things they'll have to look at is their defensive performance, their what they gave on defense. And I thought it was very lacking out beyond the first quarter. They didn't give me much effort, other than the start of the third quarter. They haven't given much effort defensively. That's a big reason as to why they're losing this ball game.
Well, here we have right now, there's some defensive pressures on, but they didn't get the turnover that they were looking for, but they did force.
Well, they draw the foul.
And Von Hutchinson, official making the call. As you have Marco Beckford going to the line to shoot two.
First free throw looks good out of the hands, and it does fall down.
I absolutely do not like Marco Beckford's shot. If you watch his shot, it looks like a palm shot. There's no control or rotation on the ball, but he gets it to go. How do you fix that? How do you address that? You see the rotation on the ball is like
it's almost like a knuckleball.
Right.
And that's a bad offensive rebound to give up if you're Anatol Rogers.
The score now 50-36 as Marco Beckford handles the ball as a penetration. He pulls it back out, 7:28 in the quarter. Turns it over. Jason McCarty got a hand on it.
Oh, good. Good pass ahead. And again, they don't complete. But the basket will count. Again, the hand in the net is going to be called a goaltending.
Oh, they called it a goaltending,
yes.
But there was no foul. Okay.
No foul in the play. Pushing it ahead. Defense does not stop the basketball. Another good block by Calvert underneath. Again, good defense by Calvert, and they come away with a loose ball. Got to get it away. McCarty inside, left hand, no good. Gets his own rebound off the glass. McCarty, boy, Johnny on the spot. Finally, his efforts are rewarded, and he's able to score. Lead down to 10 again.
So you have Anton Williams handling the ball at the floor now. High screen and roll. The way Anatol Rogers is fouling, they will be in the bonus with 3 minutes left to go in this game. And that's not a good sign.
And a whistle has stopped play. A couple of substitutions will be coming in for both sides. And some free throws coming up now for CC Sweeting as Anton Williams going to the line. Williams.
That's the friendly
roll. As they say, he had a lot of iron in that diet. Let's see if he
And if you look at him, he's a very small kid, small frame, but he has a lot of big heart. He's still very strong when he handles the ball. You know, Coach Adley coined this term. Nobody really bumps him off the ball. He can still handle, he's still strong, don't mind the small frame. But he says he's about 15 pounds away from being an elite small guard.
Well, we'll see as time goes by. And CC forcing another turnover.
And that's something that coach has always talked to Brandon about. He hangs on to the ball too much. He got a good play, he got the turnover. He forced the turnover, picked the ball up and extended on the outlet. He wants to handle the rock and, you know, he's supposed to be the team's leader. He has to make better decisions than that.
And, you know, I find that to be the case with a lot of our young Bahamian point guards, guards, is that they have that tendency, like you say, to want to over-dribble and try to do a little bit too much rather than understanding. And I guess that comes with time. Hopefully they learn the nuances of the game and understanding the ball does move a little bit better when you pass it and not try to dribble leather off the thing, but it is what it is.
And Cassius Turnquist just got a foul called on him. He came up and was putting some defensive pressure on. Now you see they got the big man on the top of the defense. They ran Jason off the three-point line.
McCarty really working hard, and he finally gets to the end there. He's got a couple of nice offensive rebounds and put back there. He's the littlest guy pretty much on the floor.
Yeah, he and
Carnotaur Rogers, but he's got good hustle. He's got a motor that doesn't quit, doesn't he?
Right.
A foul called. Overly aggressive on the defense. And, you know, we talked about maybe it is a sign of fatigue. I think they're going to get called.
Yeah, that's the third team foul against Carnotaur Rogers.
Yeah, I think that's on Paul Caradice. That's his first personal, but, you know, a lot of it, the fouls that are being called in the paint area is due to really bad rotation. McCarty.
Just now, he was fooled with the volleyball lines on the floor, thinking that was
over and back.
Right.
Yeah. Well, can Anatol Rogers make a final push? Can he make another run? That's a long three-point shot in and out.
That was halfway down.
Heartbreak for Kirkland Farrington. He's taken a couple of deep ones, has not had them work out for him. Drive baseline, quick off the glass, and in. Using the rim as a defender, gets the reverse layup.
See, like I said, he has his good moments and he has his bad moments. Is that Anton Smith?
Yes.
You know, sometimes he overhandles. Just now he made a good decision. I prefer when he plays off the ball, someone else controls the ball and they use him as a cutter. Then we go on the replay.
And you see no defensive rotation coming over to stop that drive baseline. You got to push him to the middle.
Put one foot
on
the baseline.
That's right. It's one of the coaching 101. They teach you that. Put a foot on the baseline. Don't give up that drive. As he misses the free throw, luckily.
Wide right.
Can't complete the first three-point play. And McCarty has his pocket picked by Williams, and he puts it in.
Like I said, he has his good moments. And now he put two good moments back to back. That's going to get him a little fired up.
Good spin into the lane. Kicks it out to McCarty for three. No good.
It was a good look.
Yeah, I like the look when he throws it away. McCarty a little bit too unselfish that time. Throws it into a packed defensive area, and it's a turnover. 56-42. Time is running out now for Anton Rogers. They want to talk things over. Coach McCoy says, give me a sec, timeout.
And as we look at it now, Anatol Rogers will be forcing CC Sweeting to shoot free throws from now in. He has five team fouls total on their side now, so CC Sweeting will be on the bonus line straight through for each foul's called. I was generous, I said, with about 3 minutes left. There's 4.5 minutes left to go in the game, and CC Sweeting will be shooting the ball on each foul possession.
Wow, they're already in the bonus.
Already in the bonus.
That's a tough, well, it's good and it's bad. Anatol Rogers does stop the clock. And the pressure is on CC Sweeting to make those free throws.
I'm looking at Dominic Bridgewater in the background right now with his hoodie on. I know he's like Yeah, you know, if I was in this
he's
game,
only wishing that he could be on that
totally
floor. Absolutely.
Different situation right now. Yeah, but if we're going to see him come to Campbell, we may see him come to the national tournament.
Yeah, how badly would he love to be out there on the floor at this stage?
Brandon Strong just made one of two free throws. The second one coming up now, as we mentioned earlier. This is winning in the bonus. And he makes two. 57-22. Oh, how the lead just crept back up.
Just like that.
Farrington just penetrated, Lynn Farrington just penetrated and drew the foul on Ethan Munnings as he's going to go to the line and take two free throws.
You know, it's about basketball being about momentum and everything else. And the momentum shifted in this game early on. It has not shifted, well, briefly to start the third quarter, shifted back. But like the energy that was exerted by Anatol Rogers to get back to that game, cut it down to six, just simply too long, too much to sustain, and hard to keep going. And a disappointing performance for them as this game gets closer and closer to an ending. Doesn't look as if they're going to be able to come back. But what do you take away from this if you're Anatol Rogers and you're Coach McCoy? What can you take away from this as you go and try to get your team to regroup for tomorrow night?
Yeah, from what I've analyzed from being here, commentating with you, is that Anatol Rogers needs to understand that they must get back on the defensive possessions. They need to, they can't just have one good quarter rebounding the ball. They need to keep CeCe Sweeting off the boards. They did a good job in the first quarter going after the 50-50 balls. They need to continue to do that throughout the whole game. They need to not foul so much, or if they do foul, it has to be meaningful fouls.
That's going to be over and back. That time the line was the problem. 1 foot over, 1 foot back, and that's a violation.
In actuality, the rule would be,
well, he caught it with the ball on the front side, and then he came back.
But however, yeah, if both feet were on, with 1 foot,
never
if he straddled,
this,
if he straddled
right,
the line,
yeah,
if he never brought both feet over to the front, but at that particular point in time, the player didn't know where he was because in the middle of the floor, the NSA sign,
yeah,
hides where the actual line is. But the officials use their judgment and see.
Yeah. Well, either way, it's a turnover, and now CeCe Sweeting is in full.
But back to your point about what Anatol Rogers has to do, there's a lot of work. I don't know if they can probably turn it all around in one game. However, it's a lot of work that they need to do in order to come back and try to force a game through.
Well, whatever, it's got to be done in one game, because if not, this series is over tomorrow. So they don't have a lot of time to get it right.
And you saw CeCe Sweeting's coach, the principal, during the opening announcements, said that, hey, we're going to finish this tomorrow night.
His back foot scores again underneath for CeCe Sweeting. Jump shot again, air ball, good pressure as Money comes down with a rebound. And here comes CeCe Sweeting. They're just trying to just kind of run this thing out now. They're in no hurry whatsoever, and right, and deservedly so. They've established themselves as the better team in this first game, and now it's just about persevering and finish it off.
If you notice, they're playing in 1-4 flat, sending a high speed and roll, but you're not going to take that ball away from Anton Wiggins. He's a very good ball handler. He makes good decisions.
Well, after that, though.
Well, he never had control of the ball.
Gives it to Munnings, who wasn't maybe ready for that pass. I think he thought
he's
maybe
still learning,
shoot.
And they have a challenge with that in their game, trying to get the big men involved and trying to get them to hold on to it. But I don't see how the official made the traveling call this now when he was on the back of it and didn't see that Ethan did not maintain any control of the ball.
The pressure still being applied by CC, and they come up with a pressure basket again, and now you can see they're in. They're just having fun out there. It's playtime now. This is garbage time.
And Marco Beckford is a very good finisher. He penetrates well, he controls his body well, and he's able to finish the basketball well.
As you can see, the lead has ballooned.
Back to 19 points.
19 points, which is the biggest lead that this as we've seen so far. They can push it actually.
I heard the sideline announcer say that It was up to 24 at a point in time, but I know the I biggest it was 18.
That. I thought the biggest, this is actually the largest
this
lead in my memory.
Yeah.
62-44 now if he made the first free throw, can't hit both. Rebound to CC Sweeting. And again, just comfortably in front now, just playing out the string. Strong can't hit the ugly looking floater, but again, he's been making that thing. Why
well, that's not?
Not
Strong, that's Beckford just now. Okay. He took a little wild shot.
I think Beckford was a heat check.
Yeah.
Basket going the other way for Anatole Rogers. That's Kevin Thompson who's able to score. The baskets have been rare and hard to come by for the Timberwolves in this second half.
Anton Williams has turned the ball over, dribbled it off his feet. Getting a little fancy. Like you say, it's garbage time now, so, you know, not taking it too seriously. You know, we're up a certain amount of points and 2:18 left to go. But I still want you to take care of my boy.
Second and fourth quarter were not good for Anton Rogers. They have long droughts where they just could not get any kind of offensive rhythm going. And the end result is what we're seeing now, a lopsided score. It's got to be a blocking foul, I would think.
He didn't take the contact.
He was out of the
no foul zone, but he didn't absorb the contact.
Yeah, he fell long before the offensive player got to him, and the referee was all over it. Free throws coming up. Again, at the line, Anton Rogers is Kevin Thompson.
Yeah. He makes the first one.
Thompson's had himself a pretty solid performance in his limited minutes on the floor.
So now Anatole brings the pressure all the way up to the full court.
And I think what has happened here, if you haven't noticed, is that Anatole Rogers has taken their starters off the floor. Just a quick reminder, news is following the game as is presented here. We'll have our 10 o'clock newscast coming your way immediately following, so be sure and stay tuned for that. This one just about over.
But what I neglected to do this evening, tonight is my daughter's birthday, Antoinette Francis. She celebrates her ninth birthday today. And I invited them out to the game, but my wife and my daughter, they had some other errands to do today. You know, she's still in birthday mood, sharing the cupcakes and stuff like that today at a class party and stuff like that. So, you know, I'm thinking she's probably almost to bed right now.
Probably.
If they did come out tonight, they would be hanging out with us for a bit, you know. But I have to say happy birthday to my baby.
What's her name again?
Antone.
Oh, okay. So you gave a name there after daddy.
Yes.
Baby. Okay.
Yes.
Well, my daughter's name is Marcia.
Ah.
So hey, you got to do it.
Good stuff. Good stuff. So what do you think Coach McCoy is saying right now?
You know what? I think he just wants his team to finish strong. We're losing, yes. We're going to lose, yes. But don't go out like quitters.
Right.
Keep
Have
playing.
Have some dignity, show
yeah.
some effort.
And I think that's the main thing. He's telling his guys, keep playing. Let's play until the final whistle. He's got his starters on the bench. This is a great time for these guys that normally don't play a lot of minutes to maybe show coach a little something for game two and maybe get some more playing time.
As the music was playing us now, you see CC Sweeting's players, they're very loose.
Yeah,
they're
they were dancing, singing.
Some of them was dubbing just now.
And that, you know, when you're winning, everything's good.
Yeah.
All is well with the world once you're on the upside of the score. Well, not the prettiest looking shot, but it falls for him. Minute 43.
I do not like that sideline.
That should have been thrown away, but it wasn't. And while a whistle, they stopped the clock.
The legs weren't fresh. And like I said, I wonder, I'm going to see how the officials call this. You know, they talk to us about the new rule. Anything under 2 minutes, fouling without going for the ball just to stop the clock and extend the game. Phoebe wants to clean it up. They want to stop it for long.
And speed the game up and make it a little bit.
Yeah, they want to stop the hack the shot game.
Certainly, and I can agree with that. It does tend to get, from a viewership standpoint, it gets boring. It's not good basketball. Right. I understand the reasoning behind it because you're trying to give yourself an opportunity, but
it also comes in with coaching and developing and training, because now coaches, you have to be mindful of what the new rules are.
Certainly.
You have to be able to make your players understand what the new rules are and teach them and instruct them how to actually execute another technique.
So we're down to the final minute 36. There is a timeout called, I think, by Coach Boleg this time, wanting to. And what would he be telling his guys right now? Does he say, let's continue to execute, let's not fall into bad habits, you know, that type of situation?
Because at the same time, you still want to finish strong. Maybe you don't want to just run up the score or whatever the case may be and show your opponent some respect. That's something that's big in the United States now. Don't run the score up, don't do this or that. But you still want to play strong. You don't want to necessarily give the other team any positive momentum going into the next game.
And you saw some of the Anatol Rogers fans up there. They're sitting on their hands now. This game got away, and they have very little cheer about this stage. And still, you see CeCe Sweeney still playing good defense, still getting after every shot, contesting, and making it difficult on Anatol Rogers, perhaps not wanting to have any reason to feel confident that you can win tomorrow night.
Exactly. So that's why I'm saying I believe that CeCe Sweeney still wants to finish strong with a block there. CeCe Sweeney maintains control. Marco Beckford handling the ball.
Close to an 8 second, but instead they'll get the foul. And for those of you that maybe haven't watched basketball in a while, the 10 second rule has changed to 8 seconds now. You got 8 seconds to get the ball over half court, as opposed to what it used to be 10 seconds before. And don't forget, guys, coming up immediately following this broadcast will be our 10 o'clock newscast, obviously a little beyond 10 due to the length of this ball game. But as soon as it's, we're going to switch right over to our newscast, and you'll be able to catch it in its entirety right here on RTV.
Marco Beckford converts 2 free throws. Is now a 17-point lead. A minute 20 left to go in game one of this GSSA Senior Boys Basketball Championships.
68-50, an 18-point lead. Down to the final minute 15 to play. A quick turnover going the other way. They'll get an easy layup. Lead up to 20 now. And again, they throw it away. Coach Bullock, you may want to call the hounds off now. And maybe this is trying to really demoralize Anatol Rogers, keeping the pressure on and just not giving him any breathing room.
What I'd like to see right now, Anatol Rogers, you know, don't foul anymore.
Yeah, exactly.
There's no chance. And this is a part of the spirit of that rule. You know, no, don't prolong this game. You have no chance. It's not like you're down 2, not like you're down 5.
And with under a minute with 20 points, there's no coming back at this stage. Just play it out and regroup and come back tomorrow.
Because I don't care if Anatol Rogers had Michael Jordan, LeBron James, and Kobe Bryant with a minute left to go, went down 20.
Some of the crowd heading for the exits now as they understand this thing is done. And I guess we'll see what happens tomorrow night. I'm certainly Coach McCoy will not sleep as he tries to figure out some type of game plan that's going to give his team a chance to get back into this series. 70-50, a 20-point lead for CeCe Sweeting. The Cobras have struck first, no pun intended, and appear to be in control. Well, that was a lie. That was an intended pun. But
at the same time, I wanted the game to kind of go through. I was not going to make that call to stop.
I know, right? I would have let it go.
And what makes me laugh is I know Dondre has worked so much on that move. He's trying to see if he can get the dream shake.
Oh, is that right?
Yes. You notice he did a reverse pivot and tried to step through. So I guess, Van saw something that we didn't see.
And they'll turn it over. CeCe Sweeney will have it. Let's see if they just try to run the clock out. I would just pull it out. Just pull it out and burn the clock. No need to pressure it. No need to try to do too much. And again, you know, as soon as he went to that basket, I like the idea they stole it away. Let's see what they can do on the other side. They score. So a little bit of a moral victory. They'll get it
the
under
20.
The
clock should be running. They're up 20 plus points. It should not stop on the converted basket.
And they get the steal here. So two quick buckets, but too little, too late. Basket by Kelvin Thompson. He made three straight. Can he make it three straight? I should say no. And that's the whistle. Finally, it's over. That's the good news. If you're
your final score, CeCe Sweeney Cobra 70 over Anatole Rogers Timberwolves 54. Game one is in the books for the GSSA Senior Boys Championships.
And there you get to see some of the fans up there as they wipe this thing out. Tomorrow night, we'll be back. In the meanwhile, the news here on RTV. Good night, everybody.
And to the news, that's what it is.
That's it.
10 o'clock news.
There we go. See you guys tomorrow night.